Thank you. Thank you. Oh, you got Ross Clark first. Bye, Pyro. Have fun today. Hi, Cat. Hi, Holly. Izzy. Oh my gosh. All right.
Thank you.
Good morning, lovelies. Zoe 2.7 is my Pokemon Go Explorer. And today, we're going to give you a little bit of a guide on how to get from level 41 to...
Thank you. también.
Thank you.
許しを請うのです。いくらめよ。
maybe if you haven't read it, just sort of frame it. I'll just read it out loud, and then we'll sort of go back and forth and see what we can do before you see play this. I've watched a lot of your content, and while I'm not a deep follower of the Red Pill, I'm certainly interested in becoming the most ideal man I can, and I'm glad you support men. I found the Red Pill years ago and realized how important status and confidence is for maintaining attraction. I understand hypergamy. I used to be more naive, but I still get one. I used to a lot. The reason why I'm requesting a video, by the way, guys, if you want to request a video, pin.
Who faces more rejection, men or women?
Honestly, I want to say men.
It's like this keep telling me and acting like he don't want nothing to do with me, but what does that have to do with me?
Of me even saying yes for a first actual date. So that takes a toll.
Okay, so a 5-star restaurant in Miami, how much is that going to range?
Depends how many drinks you'll be ordering.
Average.
Anywhere from 300 to 800, maybe.
What's a red flag in dating that you used to ignore that you would now, if you saw it, you would like run in the direction?
I think hygiene is like huge. Brush your teeth.
Before we go any further, let me share the comment of the day. Shout out to the Wombat 2012. He said, "Anyone who thinks women uplift one another and support their sisters obviously haven't worked in an office with a majority workforce of women." Holy shit, the backstabbing, the snide comments, the undermining of other women, etc., etc. It's an eye-opener. This comment hits the nail on the head. I've always found it interesting how there's this narrative that women uplift each other, yet in certain settings, it becomes evident that some women are the first to bring down their so-called sisters. The pettiness, snide remarks, and passive-aggressive behavior undermine the very essence of camaraderie. In fact, it's often been said that many individuals, women included, would prefer not to have a female boss. Let's not forget it's often women who slut-shame other women than guys do. If women are supposed to be each other's biggest cheerleaders, why do we see such conflicting behaviors? Please don't forget to reach out to us by email to claim your $5. As usual, guys, I'll pick one comment from each video. It may be the funniest, the most liked, or one that touched me, so don't forget to leave a comment and you may be our next winner. Make sure to hit the like and subscribe buttons too, guys, as it helps a lot. And now, back to the video.
How old are you?
28.
Let's say I wanted to take you out. How much do you expect me to spend on a first date?
Depends where we're going.
What's your expectation, though?
I don't really have any.
Stop the cap.
So I could hit you up and say, hey, let's go to Burger King and get slushy.
No. I mean, at least like, you know, nice 5-star kind of restaurant, and then depending on how it goes, depending how I like you, and that all kind of goes with me even saying yes for a first actual date. So that takes a toll.
Okay. So 5-star restaurant in Miami, how much is that gonna range?
Depends how many drinks you'll be ordering.
Average.
Anywhere from 300 to 800, maybe. Jumpstart, yeah.
So, realistically, you expect a man to spend $800 on a first day?
Yeah.
All right, fellas, let's dissect what we just watched, shall we? First off, I find it funny how she tried to sound classy with the initial uncertainty she displayed about not having any expectations, but was swiftly thrown out of the window as soon as he implied he won't spend much on the first date. How dare he not throw his life savings away on a 28-year-old who probably has had what's now? And detachment. Faith. Sure, Not all women have unreasonable expectations, but it only takes one bad experience to make one overly cautious. For many men, it feels like a gamble where the stakes are just too high. So, while your perspective is truly commendable, the reality on the ground is that genuine connections are becoming rarer by the day. Five-star restaurant for a one-star chick. Five-star restaurant on the first date? She should appreciate getting a value meal at McDonald's. Say the truth.
Emotional, damn it!
28 and ran through with absolutely nothing to show for it. Cat food at the ready, she belongs to the streets. Avoid women like this, generally. She went from no expectations to five-star restaurant real quick. Yep, that's modern women for ya. If you stay quiet and listen, they usually tell on themselves. That's why she's 28 and still single. Depending on how she likes you, you get the honor of spending even more money on her after a five-star dinner. She doesn't even know how much dinner costs, because she never paid for it in her life. If I gotta pay for an $800 first date, I need the Hofax, and I need to see you without all that clown makeup. And I need to see how you're living, and then I'm gonna laugh, because who's paying that much for the get-to-know-you phase?
What's a red flag in that you would now if you saw it?
So when would you say 10 out of 10 is refund again? Hashtag Starfield, parentheses, this game is an unfinished buggy mess. So you see there's the order confirmation right there, ordered from Steam, $184 in real money, that is $100 because obviously he had to get the refund, New Zealand dollars, a little bit different. Anyway, so he did get his money back, and Starfield is no longer in his library. He has moved past that. And he made a tweet, and he said this. He said, Diablo 4 is better than Starfield, and Diablo 4 is bad. Wow. So let's see. I saw people linking these some clips of Quinn. Oh, he beat the game? Well, I'm sorry to hear that. That's horrible. That happened to him.
Like, D4 is better than Starfield. And D4 is bad.
Yo, there we go! That is what I call success! That is what I call success! Alright, to be fair, it was mostly advertised. It's not, the game isn't even fucking finished. It is a buggy mess, and yeah, let me tell you. Jesus, bro, so he actually got his shit refunded.
Content creators, and they're turning them into shills. They're getting content creators, and they're turning them into shills. By doing this fucking early access, good boy behavior gets the good boy biscuits.
Who was it? I said this shit was gonna happen. Like, I did. I said this shit was gonna happen because it's common sense.
Routine. And I don't know, we need to call out the companies for doing it. And we did it. It's just so toxic, and it's also so anti you guys, the consumers, like anyone who's buying the games. Because guess what? They're basically just rigging. It's like rigging the reviews, it's rigging the public perception.
I'm so glad to hear Quinn say this. I'm actually so happy to hear him say this because he is the only person that I've ever heard speak up about this. And I'm going to replay it just so you guys completely understand the context. I'm going to go to the full mod.
Team companies. Mainly talk to me. The community manager there actually does talk to me. He also, I mean, I want to talk to him. He will still reply, but not publicly. I am blacked. Like, no, I am absolutely blacked. I'm not trying to get back in that club. That's the whole thing. I fucking hate that. I like to just play a game, and then I just say what I think about a game. And I feel like this is a talk. toxic thing that is happening in the gaming industry right now, where these large AAA game companies, they're getting content creators and they're turning them into shills with our, you know, by doing this fucking early access good boy behavior against the good boy biscuits routine. And I don't know, we need to call out the companies for doing it, and we need to, it's just so toxic, and it's also so anti you guys, the consumers, like anyone who's buying the games, because guess what, they're basically just rigging, it's like rigging the reviews, it's rigging the public perception, because people trust content creators, they trust streamers, and if the streamer's saying it's good, they're gonna be like, if I say a game's good, you're gonna, generally speaking, all you guys are gonna be like, oh shit, I might play that, or if someone else says a game's good that you watch and you enjoy, guess what, you're gonna consider playing that. I don't think so. Yeah, that's how it works. That's literally how it works. There's a reason why they call streamers influencers, okay? Because they use an influence. That's a reality. And if they're able to do that, I don't know, man.
I called this shit out 2 fucking years ago, and I said that this was problematic and it was bad for consumers. And now, finally, 2 fucking years later, somebody else finally sees the big picture. They finally see the big picture of why it's a bad idea and why it's consumer unfriendly that some people get access to things early whenever they have a positive relationship with the company. And the way that it is bad is because those people are the ones that put the first impression in the minds of the viewers, and they define the conversation about the product. And these individuals are used as marketing tools, and there is a positive profit incentive for them to provide favorable coverage to these video games and to other things as well. Again, this is an overall issue. I apologize for the flashbang, but this is the fucking reality. It is called access journalism, and it is older than video games itself. And I said this shit was gonna happen, and people said, oh, companies should be able to let people do whatever they want. They should be able to do whatever they want. Well, of course they should be able to do whatever they want, but that doesn't mean that they should do it. It's problematic. It puts, and it negatively hurts. It hurts the streamers, what, for 8 hours? Oh my God, I think I'll live. But who does it really hurt? You. It hurts you. Because the person who receives the early copy, who then has a positive incentive to provide favorable coverage to that video game, now is going to provide that favorable coverage more than if it was done equally. And whenever that favorable coverage is applied, and you say, you know what? Maybe I'm gonna drop the fucking Benjamin. Maybe I'm gonna spend $100. Well, guess what happens? Todd got you again. It just works. And it does. And that's why the companies do it. I said this shit was gonna happen. It's happening now. And it will continue to happen. Thank you so much, Quinn. Quinn is the first person I have ever heard speak out against this. And to ever explain the problem to the audience. Like, fucking massive W for me. This is, I get it. I have never had anybody else, I've never heard anybody else say this. No, I can wait for early access journalists who are paid to support their paycheck. The point is that people that are given early access, and if the early access is only given to certain individuals, then it creates a winners and losers situation. And it is favoritism with like streamer politics, sure. But like, you know, you manage that and you play the game. But the real people who lose out is the audience. And I'll give you an example of how this happens. Reasons you should not trust Metacritic scores. Hashtag Starfield. Metacritic's went down to 86 today. due to the So Video Games podcast review 65. They played 5 hours, one mainline quest and 1 to 2 side missions, and called it quits with some of the worst takes I've ever seen. So this is the this is what they said about Starfield. Starfield is a pretty good time. It's basically Fallout 4 in space with some sci-fi and procedural generation. Thank you, ChatGPT. I really appreciate that. Special episode Starfield, the chat review. Here we go. It's so funny. We both played about 4 to 5 hours. I was pretty close to 5 hours, if not a little bit longer than that. These are what you like to call hardcore gamers. Ooh, hardcore gamers right here. There it is. Number one, I hate the city. I hate the way you've been in it. Right. I'm good where I'm at now. Yep, there you go. And we're flipped because I don't like a lot of power. And by the way, this is again negative view. Join your negative. Don't even think this is a system. This is what happens. Imagine getting paid to say a good thing about a company. No. I have no problem with people taking sponsorships. I have no problem with it. Because I take sponsorships. Oh, and by the way, guys, I will still take any early access copy I can get. Because you know what? It's beneficial to me, and I'll always do it. However, it is harmful to the industry, and you should get mad at the companies for doing it. However, this is what I'm trying to say. Is that whenever you have a sponsorship, you have to disclose if you are doing an ad, a hashtag ad. And because of that, users are now able to know that this is a sponsor, this is a promotion, and it is not supposed to be taken as an objective review in the same way than if it was not sponsored. Taking sponsorship is one thing, but will you give your honest opinion about the game? I did. I've given my honest opinion about the game 50 times. I've given it 50 times. To Ubisoft's credit, they give early access to anyone, even those that regularly criticize them. I don't know if they do that. If that's the case, then yeah, W's for them. They've been scared of taking an early copy of the game knowing it would be bad. Hey guys, I hope you're having an amazing day. I want to start by asking a simple question. Will single moms ever accept that when men desire them is just for sex? The answer is no. They love being wanted for sure, but they also love help. Yeah, a guy that supports them in every aspect while she only treats him as an option. Single moms love bragging about how much men approach them, but in reality, they show no signs of a ring. Check this out.
Sex. We have to catch up. I have been on so many dates recently. I have just been approaching men. Just walking up to men. The other day, I was swimming at the beach and there was a guy in the ocean and I just swam right out to him. Almost drowned, but swam right out to him and was treading water for my life and just chatting away to him, which was great. It was amazing. He was 24, very young, but you know what? That's fine. You know, it's for the plot. The airport, and I was looking at the guy just staring at him in the eyes. And he came over to me while another man was chatting me out. I was like, are you guys together? And I said, no. And he's like, can I take you out? Absolutely, you can take me out, especially if you're going to ask me in front of another guy. Me and him went on the best date I've ever been on in my life. Then today, I approached another guy at the beach. The point of this is just play big. Be bold. Approach people. Walk up to people. It's for the plot, and it's not even for the plot. Like, who cares about getting rejected? Life is one big game, really. It is one big game that we are all leaving the same way. You may as well make it interesting and just be fucking bold. Be bold. That's my thought. That's the catch up.
That woman right there is a symbol. Suddenly, she dates a guy and happens to be perfect. And what does she do after that? Move on to another man because she wants to find bigger and better deals. Women are hard to please these days. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome to another one of my videos. Today, we're going to be talking about the confusing things that men say, but men, before in the comments, you say that women are confusing too. Maybe we'll do a future episode on the confusing things that women say. But we did put out the word on my Instagram, at the Matthew Hussey, for those of you who aren't following me yet. We put out a word and said, what's something confusing a man has said to you? So we're going to read you some of these things today. In fact, the wonderful Audrey is going to read us some of these things, and I am going to be attempting to dissect them, which Lord knows isn't easy. All right, let's go. What's the first one?
You're the kind of girl you marry.
Well, it's flattering you, isn't it? First, it's saying there are qualities about you that one would look for in a long-term partner, but it's also kind of... I don't know what he said after that, but I feel like I'm not the only one in the room who thinks that that came with some kind of excuse about him not being ready. When you say, no, you're the kind of person you marry, not the kind of person you date, that to me is a way of saying, and I'm the kind of person who's only willing to date right now, and therefore I can't proceed with you. It might also, from being really honest, be kind of... you that this person isn't sexually attracted. You have wonderful qualities. I don't feel that chemistry with you. Otherwise, I'd be trying to jump in my head.
Two, we have,
I like you too much to be with you. So, I like you too much to be with you. That says to me, I am absolutely 100% going to hurt you. I like you too much to be with you is a way of saying I'm not serious, so I'm not going to invest in you in any real way, but I do like you. I like you enough that, you know, we should probably have sex, but I don't want to go any further than that. But it's also, again, notice the pattern here, flattery. I like you too much to be with you. Notice it's flattery, but it's confusing flattery. If you think about it, it's quite clever, because it says, I'm flattering you, I'm dazzling you with a compliment, at the same time as telling you that I can't give you any more than I'm giving you right now. So I'm simultaneously piquing your interest and giving you a reason to keep trying with me, while excusing myself from trying at all with you.
They then ended things, and 2 weeks later, he came back and said, I need you in my life. I love you. Let's try again.
Well, that to me is, I used the analogy recently of, he jumped ship, decided that this ship wasn't one that he wanted to be on anymore. Maybe he hadn't wanted to be on it for a long time, but he finally got up the courage to leave. Maybe he never felt the way he really wanted to feel deep down. Or maybe, you know, he's confused about what love actually is, and there's this grass.
Yeah. Yeah!
April. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you. identity!
Yeah.